a practicing Hindu has to be vegetarian. You cannot say no to the existence of animals. Listen. People come up with the argument, oh, plants also have pain, plants also have life. When you can eat them, why not animals? Listen, plants have not developed the muscle memory to store the pain in them. So they do not existentially feel the pain. They do feel some kind of a alternation happening in them, but do not feel the pain. Pain as one of the important quality, getting stored and ability to replay itself is one of the important quality of the pain, which does not exist in plants. Please understand, getting stored and ability to replay itself is one of the important DNA qualities of pain. Plants don't have that. That is why eating plants, agricultural products are allowed. I can give you tons of examples. Naturally, human body is created for vegetarian lifestyle. And I am also warning the whole world. Within next 15 years, you will be able to support the whole population with food only if you decide to turn vegetarian. Because 30 pounds of food is necessary to make 1 pound flesh. Understand, 30 pounds of agricultural food, which can be directly consumed by us, is necessary to produce 1 pound flesh. So vegetarianism, vegetarian lifestyle is the most affordable. I tell you, just by being vegetarian, you are doing annadana, giving food for thousands of people. Whenever you consume a vegetarian meal, you are already giving meal to 29 people. Because you are not taking away 30 persons' food into one meal. Understand? If you are consuming vegetarian food, already you are serving food for 29 people. So understand, every time you put your hand on the vegetarian food, remember, 29 more people are blessing you for letting them have food. All practicing Hindus have to be vegetarian because saying no to life is most dangerous. You don't have the right to say no to life. Actually, plants are also life, no doubt, but they have not developed a biomemory where the pain is stored and gets inside your system and creates pain. No. So if you consume them, if you consume plants, vegetables, there is no pain going inside your system along with it. There is no biomemory going inside. Pure energy, food, only that goes inside. But with a animal, the muscles have a capacity to store muscle memory and bio memory. So when the animals are killed, they leave a tremendous pain, suffering. They are not going to say, let the whole world be blissful and die. No. They leave so much of suffering and die that gets recorded in that muscle memory and bio memory. When you eat that, you will fall into depression for a small reason. Your husband late from the office for 5 minutes is enough to make him as a late husband. Understand? No. For a very small reason, you fall into depression because your bio memory is prone to depression. Understand? When you are eating the dead animal's flesh, you are also eating the muscle memory, bio memory recorded in it. That becomes part of you. You become prone to that pain. You become prone to that pain. That's the reason I request you to be a vegetarian. Please understand. Even if you are a seeker, without vegetarian lifestyle, you will not achieve anything. Vegetarian life is a basic need. Not only vegetarian lifestyle, not eating anything grown out of chemicals, pesticides and fertilizers. Chemicals, pesticides and fertilizers try to become more and more organic because chemicals create a toxic mental setup in your system. I am giving you the straight conclusions. Try to become more and more natural, organic consumer. It is good for your seeking, good for your mental balance, good for you. Overall, it is good for your enlightenment and manifesting all these powers.